write down dipole in a uniform magnetic field. Dipole in a uniform okay, so what we have done till now is we have found out magnetic field due to a dipole moment, but we haven't yet discussed what happens to a dipole inside a magnetic field. Okay, so this is what we are going to study now. It's like this: you finding electric field due to an electric dipole, okay, and then finding what will happen to the electric dipole in external electric field. Okay, fine. So similarly here, we have found out the magnetic field due to a magnetic dipole moment, and now we are finding what will happen to magnetic dipole moment in external magnetic field. Okay, now you know, just like electric dipole moment will experience a torque which is equal to P cross E. This is torque on electric dipole moment. Similarly, the magnetic field can create a torque on magnetic dipole moment, which is equal to M cross B. Okay, so torque, magnetic torque will be zero if angle between M and B is 0 or 180 degrees. Okay, for example, this is the magnetic dipole moment. This is, let us say, M. This could be due to solenoid, due to bar magnet, whatever it is, it doesn't matter. Ultimately, it is M only. Okay, so suppose this is magnetic dipole moment M. Fine, and you have a magnetic field also along the same direction. So torque will be zero. Okay, now if magnetic dipole moment is like this, and this is the magnetic field B, again torque will be zero. Okay, then what is the difference between these two scenarios? How they are different? Now let us see. If this is the magnetic dipole, let us say this is the magnetic field B, okay, and what you're doing is you're taking a dipole moment and you're rotating it little bit. Suppose you rotate it in such a way that this angle is theta. Okay, now tell me which direction the magnetic moment will experience the torque. Will it increase the theta or will it decrease the theta, the torque which this magnetic dipole moment will feel? Just message it. Increase or decrease? Kushal is saying that it will increase the angle. Like if I just keep it at angle theta with the magnetic field, the angle will increase. As in automatically, okay, Ritvik is also saying same thing. Automatically it will start rotating that direction. All of you, anybody says that it will decrease? Okay, Vaishnavi is having an opposing point. It will decrease. Anyways, the answer is that it will decrease. You can see that there are two vectors, right? This is one vector M and this is another vector B. So if you consider the cross product, which is M cross B, which direction that direction of this cross product will be? It will be clockwise, isn't it? It will be clockwise. So magnetic dipole moment M will feel a clockwise torque M cross B. And that is the reason why theta will decrease. Ritvik and Kushal, are you clear now? Right. So that is why it will decrease. Okay. So it will try to regain theta equal to 0 degrees. Okay. So it tries to go back to its original position. Okay. Now let us see this. If let us say this is the magnetic field. Okay. If this is the magnetic field and this was the original position of the magnetic dipole moment M. Fine. Right now, the angle between magnetic dipole moment and magnetic field is 180 degree. So torque is zero. But then if you rotate it slightly like this. Okay. Now, if this is angle theta. Now, what will happen? It will try to increase or decrease the angle theta. The torque on M, will it increase the angle theta or decrease the angle theta? Theta is the angle which is shown. Now, Kushal and Ritvik will not answer first. They will see. Don't become conscious. Just keep interacting. You can message anything. Okay. Just reply whatever comes in your mind. Theta will increase or decrease? Yes, now it will increase. So the torque felt by the dipole again will be in clockwise direction. Look at it, M cross B. Okay, so because of that, theta will increase. So what will happen? This will just completely rotate and align itself like this. It will try to go to theta equal to zero. Okay, so it flips. Okay, so this is unstable equilibrium. This is unstable and this is stable. Although both of them, they are equilibrium. Both of them, torque is zero. They both are in equilibrium. But one is stable equilibrium, which again go back to its original position. And the other one is unstable equilibrium. You know, we just slightly nudge it and it will completely flip over. Fine. So that is the difference between, theta equal to zero and theta equal to 180 degree. Okay. Now, one thing you need to be clear here is that, you know, I'm telling you something different here. If this is magnetic dipole moment M, okay, now here are two locations, 1 and 2. First, tell me which direction the magnetic field will be at point number 1. This or that, A, B, C or D. All of you please type at this point which direction the magnetic field will be because of this. Exactly, it will be A only. Now tell me at point number 2, A, B, C, D, which direction? At point 2, this point, what is the correct direction of magnetic field? Correct. So 2 is a point which is on equatorial plane. 2 is a point which is on equatorial plane. So magnetic field, if you recall the formula, it was equal to mu naught by 4 pi minus m by r cube along the equatorial line. So there is a minus sign. Fine. So that is why on this point 2, C is the correct direction of magnetic field. There is a minus sign, negative direction of M. M is along A direction, minus M is along C direction. Getting it? So remember these things. Okay. Now tell me this point. This one. Quickly. A, B, C, D, you know which directions A, B, C, D are. It will be along A. Okay. This point, it will be along C. Fine. So I hope this is very clear now. Okay, good. Good. Fine. Let us now take up a numerical. Long time we have done a question. Now, first I will draw a diagram. All of you, draw with me. Draw a circle which is as nice looking as this. You can't draw a better circle. This is P. First, let us draw everything, then I'll tell you what is the question. Fine, so this is the figure. I hope all of you have drawn it. Should I read out the question? Okay, the question goes like this. The figure shows a small magnetized needle P placed at a point O. So there is a dipole moment P which is fixed at the center. So this is a dipole moment that is fixed. This is P. Direction is clearly shown. This is fixed at the center. Okay. Now what you're doing is you are taking Q. Q is another dipole moment. Okay. Q is another dipole moment that you're taking, and you are placing it at six different locations as shown. Fine. So you can place it at Q1, then you can place it at Q2, Q3, Q4, Q5, and Q6. So six different places you can place the capital Q dipole moment. Okay. You need to find out. The first question is, which configuration is not in equilibrium? So we have learned about the equilibrium already. We have learned about two types of equilibrium, unstable and stable. Both are equilibrium only, but different kinds of equilibrium. So right now I am not differentiating between the kind of equilibrium. Okay. I am just asking you which configuration are not in equilibrium. You can say P and Q3, P on and Q6 like this. Okay. So just think over it and message. Once you get quickly, Vaishnavi is saying P and Q1 not in equilibrium. Let's see. What is the magnetic field direction due to P at Q1? At Q1, at this location, the direction of magnetic field due to P will be downwards. It is equatorial plane. Okay, so magnetic field is downward. So angle between this magnetic field and this Q1 dipole moment is 90 degree. So M cross B is not zero. So it will experience a torque. So P and Q1 and P and Q2, both. Here also, the angle is 90 degree between magnetic field and dipole moment. Okay, so both PQ1 and PQ2, they have... They are not in equilibrium because angle is 90 degree P PQ1 and PQ2. This is the answer. Fine. Now, can you find out which of the configuration? So Q1 and Q2, they are not in equilibrium. So there are four configurations that are in equilibrium: Q3, Q4, Q5, and Q6. You need to find which one are stable configuration and which one are unstable configurations. First, message the stable configuration. The other one will automatically be unstable. Okay. So if I take PQ5, if I take P and Q5, what is the direction of magnetic field due to P at location Q5? It is this way. Fine. And Q5 is in which direction? That is in this way. So angle is 180 degrees. So this is not stable. This is unstable. Okay. So unstable is PQ5, because angle between magnetic field due to P and the dipole moment, which is Q5, is 180 degrees. So PQ5 is unstable. What about PQ3? Saim here deleted the message. Okay, tell me, PQ3. PQ3, is it stable or unstable? Quickly. The magnetic field due to P at Q3 will be in which direction? Downside. Isn't it? So angle between this and that is 0 degree. So PQ3 is stable. Okay. Now let us take P and Q6. This is along the axis. So along the axis, magnetic field due to a dipole is along the direction of dipole. So PQ6 will be stable, because magnetic field at a location of Q6 will be along the direction of Q6. So PQ3 and PQ6, they are stable. And you can see that PQ4 will be unstable, because magnetic field due to P will be in upward direction and Q4 is downward direction. So angle is 180 degrees. So this is unstable, PQ4. Getting it? So like this, you can analyze this particular scenario. Okay, right. So let us move forward.